Hello and welcome to 9design 3D again. Today we will make some liminal space pool rooms in Blender and Unreal Engine together. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will add a cube for our scene, and after that, you can scale and place it. In tap to edit mode, choose all of it with A and Shift D to duplicate it. Choose your top faces of your cubes and get to edge mode. Under the edge, bridge edge loops. From the left middle menu, you can set it up your number of cuts. And you can give an arc shape for your cubes. And right click shade smooth, normals auto smooth. After that, delete these inner faces if you want. Choose this edge line and press F. Make same thing for the back. Choose these top edge lines and right click loop tool bridge. For the bottom part, F to fill. Scale in Y axis, and now we will add a cube for making our walls and scale it. For your arc, Shift D to duplicate it and rotate in Y axis 180. And tidy up your cube and arcs. Before all of this, for the cube, add a loop cut with Ctrl R and scale them in X axis, and add another loop cut with Ctrl R again, scale in Y axis. Choose these front faces and E to extrude them in Y axis because we will make some room type. Ctrl J to join them this, and we will add a mirror modifier. Choose your room object. In tap to edit mode, with A choose all and G to move in X axis. For the others, you can Shift D to duplicate it for side arcs, G to move them in X axis. Shift D to duplicate for these arcs and place them for the side walls. Again, you can add some mirror modifier and apply it. After all you tidy up, we will add some loop cuts for our room because we want to add little pool. Choose this middle face, I to inset. Before this, choose bottom faces and G to move them and E to extrude your pool face. Now we will add some sphere for our scene for making some geometric shape objects. Choose top faces and E to extrude these edge lines. For the making some flower pot, you can add a circle and shade smooth it. Choose all of arts and Ctrl J to join them together. Ctrl A all transform. And after that, for the room, choose a boolean modifier. As an object, select your arcs and delete them. This boolean work like that. Let's add some plaster material. We will give only color in here, but before this, under the world, you can add some sky texture or seeing our materials clearly. For the plaster, I am adding pink material in here. For the second material with the plus icon, I will add some tiles. You can find some tiles material as a marble from ambientcg.com. I will link in description. Assign your interfaces for your tiles. We will bake these two materials, so I am choosing all of them, and you and Smart UV project, set up your island margin. As you see, our UV map will look like that. You can choose some faces with the pressing L, and after that, scale them, because we want to use all the pixels in our maps. After you tidy up your UV map, go back to shading, and for the tiles material, you can set up your scale under the map. Now we will add an image texture in here. Press new button and type your liminal pool width and height. I am setting them 4K and press OK. For this, Ctrl C and Ctrl V to copy for two of your material. From the left, you can set up your material in here. In the render engine, choose your cycle. As you see, our image texture must be selected in all materials, and we have to select our pool mesh. Under the bake settings, for the base color, we will choose our diffuse map and uncheck your direct and indirect and press bake. From the left, as you see our base color texture in here, you can save it as the baked texture. And now we will get some roughness back, but before this, change your color space to non-color. It will affect all your materials. Be sure you selected it. And under the bake, we will press bake again. As you see, our roughness map came in here. For this texture, you can save it too. For the normal, we will change our bake type to the normal, and it will be non-color too. And after that, we will press bake again. Our tiles affect this normal map like this. And don't forget to save it too. Now we will choose all of our meshes and go to File, Export and FBX. Choose your path mode, copy and choose your embed texture, limit the selected object, select your mesh, under the geometry, set it face and export your FBX. In the Unreal Engine, I will set up my scene as a third person. You can choose your project location and project name, and don't forget to check your starter content. After, you can create it. Now our Unreal Engine project will be came in here like this. And now you can go File, New Level and choose Basic and Create. But we can delete this. Choose the landscape mode and as a default you can create. You can go File and Save All, give a new name for your level. Now go to Edit, Plugins and type Water. After you select your water plugins, restart your Unreal Engine. After you restart it, you can double click to your level and it came in here. From here, under the All Classes, type Water Body Ocean, drag and drop it. When your Water Body Ocean selected, type the fall off and set it as a width. And now, as you see some control vertexes in here, you can set up your island and you can set up your water body scale from them. Under the content, right click and add new folder. And after that, choose your FBX. And as a default, I will import all. Choose all your meshes with the shift selected. Drag and drop it to your scene. As you see, it came in here with materials clearly. You can put them in the ocean. Because we want to make some pool in it too, but we will use this ocean water. Under of it, we have to change our ocean wavelength. Choose your water body ocean. Under the wave source, we will change it. And under the waves, you can set up your wavelengths, minimum and maximum values. Which type pool look you want, you can set it up from here. And under the amplitude, you can set it with the chill ocean waves. This is too randy for me, so I will change my max wavelength from here, and under the direction, you can set it up. And ocean is ready. As you see, I changed some light in here with the pressing Ctrl L, continue to press Ctrl L, and you can move your mouse button and set up your sunrise or maybe sunset for the daylight and day hour. You can set your light how you want from here. For this little spheres, I will add some basic material for this. You can under the content right click and choose material. And after that, you can select your constant tree vector and connect it to the base color. Under the constant, you can set up yourself a color. And after you save, turn back to your Unreal project. Under the materials, as you see, you can drag and drop your material to them. For the others, I am making same thing. I am drag and drop my materials for my other objects. I will download something from the Quixel bridge. As the palm tree, it looks like spinless yucca. I downloaded them. Which shape you want? You can download some grass and foliages from here. After adding my project, as you see, it will came under the mega scan. You can drag and drop some tree from here. From the outside, I am adding something and I will scale it. And I will delete other tree. My scene will be look like that. From the get content under the cinematic, I will add cine camera actor. As you see, we added a camera view from here, from the right scene. You can see this. Before all of it, under the folder, you can change your camera name from here. And under the perspective, choose your lim camera main. With the WASD, you can set up your camera view from here. Under the camera settings, you can change your current focal length and set up your camera angle again. As a film bag, I'm using DSLR. Under the color grading and temperature, you can set up your tint and temperature value. How you want, if you want, you can make it a bit cold or warm, which type liminal space you work on. Under the midtones, you can set up your contrast with moving your little dot. Under set all of your camera, add level sequence. And type your own level sequence in here. Choose your lim camera from here and drag and drop to the left part. Under the transform, press this and add a keyframe for yourself. And for the last keyframe, you can add another keyframe in here. Under the edit plugins, you can choose your movie render quay and you can restart your Unreal. Under the Windows cinematics, choose your movie render quay and choose your main limb sequence. Under the export, you can get some JPEG sequence maybe. With the plus, choose your anti-aliasing. I am setting my temporal sample count with this and override anti-aliasing. If you want to get some PNG sequence, you can edit from them. Under the output, choose your output directory and set up your resolution, maybe 2K or 4K. If you want, you can use your custom frame rate. After accept, we will choose render local. It will came in here, your render preview. After compile shaders, it will start to get some render frame by frame. I made it my liminal space scene like this. I will make new scenes in the Unreal Engine and Blender together. So don't forget to check my YouTube channel. And don't forget to subscribe and like if you like it. Thank you for watching. See you later.